Well, it was a, I was telling the guys after the game, it was one of those games where we got down 1-0. They scored that goal late in the first on the power play. And then when we got down 2-0, it didn't feel like we should have been down 2-0. And we were really calm and relaxed on the bench. And we just talked about just staying with it and keep playing. We were getting chances. We were getting opportunities. And we ended up scoring those two goals in about a minute apart. And obviously, when we made it 2-1, Michael scored in the power play, gave us a lot of momentum. Then to come back and score right away, and then now all of a sudden it's an even hockey game. And then for the last, then we just tried focusing on winning the rest of the game. And you know, we've played them quite a bit in the past year. We played them 4 times in the regular season last year. We played them 3 games in the playoffs. So we played them now, so it's 8 times in the last year. And all the games have been tight. All the games have been about special teams play. And it gets emotional, some penalties, and sometimes you get out of rhythm. And I really thought our guys did a good job of sticking with it. And especially the guys that weren't on the power play or weren't killing penalties, they stuck with it. And they end up having some really good shifts for us when we got back to 5-on-5. So a lot of really good things. We're learning how to win in a lot of different games. And I like the progress that we've made. And now we got to reload, forget about tonight, and get ready for tomorrow.
Well, at that point, we had been out there for a little while, and we'd run through a few of our plays that we have set up, and none of them worked. A few of them were really close, but they were actually calling for another one. Coach might give me an elbow on the side for saying this, but I thought it was time to take a shot, so I just ripped into one and ended up working out.
I mean, everything just kind of came together tonight. Like, we were working on our power play a lot in the last couple weeks. I mean, it hasn't been going the way we've wanted to in the last few games. And, you know, to see it happen tonight was just, you know, the result of moving the puck well and just, like, believing in each other. I mean, you guys asked earlier how he knows when to shoot. But sometimes, you know, you just got to see the lane and take that shot. You know, we have a ton of set plays, but TJ was able to just step into that one. And then Mikey Barrett actually told me before when we came out on his goal that he was going to take that one-timer if we worked it all the way around. So I saw it go down and laughing and come back up to Joe. And as soon as he came over me, I saw he had a lane and just tried to one-touch it over to him. He had a great shot. I mean, passing's half of it, but Mikey did a great job picking the 5-hole there. Yeah, it's obviously great to get back to 500. I mean, obviously, we were working really hard in those first few games to try and get a W, and it didn't go our way. And, you know, we felt like we were playing great hockey, but it just didn't happen for us. And I think we've been doing really good at just sticking with our game plan. And, you know, even tonight we got down by a couple, but we just kept doing what we had to do and fighting back. And it's huge to be back at 500, but we take every game one game at a time. And, you know, now we just focus on tomorrow night and getting another 2 points. And, you know, the record takes care of itself.
That's a big point of emphasis for us because we haven't been able to do that yet this year. And in order to be a championship level team, in order to win a championship in March, you're going to have to win a semifinal game and you're going to have to win a final game. So we're trying to approach these situations with that sort of mindset and trying to gain that experience. And we've had over the last few weekends, we've had situations where we won on Friday and then we haven't played the same way on Saturday. We've talked about it. We've addressed it. We've talked about the things that we need to do from a mental perspective to get ready for that game. That, you know, each game is individual of itself. And no matter what you did on Friday night, no matter how you played, that opponent's going to try to beat you on Saturday. And they're going to give you an even better effort because they don't want to get swept. So you have to respect that, and you have to come out and play even better than you did. And I think in the early part of the year, maybe we've let down a little bit, and we thought that, oh, we got them on the ropes, they're just going to give us the game, and we found out the hard way that that doesn't happen. And that's all part about winning. That's all learning how to win. That's learning how to be the best team that we can be. And we've hopefully tomorrow night is another opportunity for us to get over that hump. And once you feel it, and once you learn what it takes from a preparation standpoint, from a mental standpoint, then the next time you get put in that situation, you're able to get through it. And like I said, for us to be the team we want to be at the end of the year, we're going to have to find a way to make that happen. And there's no better chance than tomorrow night to learn that.